Okay, this lesson is about using transitions and animations, and I just want to give you a brief introduction to those before we get started. First, what's the difference when we talk about transitions and animations? In presentations, a transition is changing from one slide to another. What happens when you go, for example, from this slide to this slide when you're presenting it? There's different transitions. Animations are things that happen on the slide itself. So that's the difference between those two. So let's look at a little bit about that. First, let's look at transitions. Okay, for a transition in PowerPoint, you go up here, and there's the menu item Transitions. And you have then a number of different transitions across here. And there are even more if you pull down here. You've got a lot of them. They have them grouped as subtle transitions, exciting ones, dynamic content. So you can experiment with these. For example, if I say to go to this slide, I'm going to use, let's just say this, let's pick out one of these. Let's pick out this shred animation. Well, you see there, it demonstrates what it's going to look like so that when I start my presentation. Here's going to be my first slide, and then when it transitions to the next slide, that's what it looks like. Okay, so that's what we're talking about with the transition. So as you add those, you can add the same one to all the slides. Like if I said I wanted them all to look like, you just click right over here where it says Apply to All. And then all of them are going to have that same transition. Or you can do a different one for each slide. I could put a ripple effect on this one that's going to look like that one transitions, whatever you want to do. So that's how you can add transitions. Okay, now animations, you can get a lot more complex here. For example, you click on the Animations tab up here. And it's helpful too if you click this that says Animation Pane over here. That opens up a window here that shows you, kind of lists all the things that are going to happen. What you have here, if we preview this slide, here's what that slide is going to look like. Okay, there was our transition, but then you see that point came in there automatically. Then I click, and we have the next one. Then I click, and that one comes in from the side. I click again, and that one comes in from the side. And click again, and that one comes in from the side. So that's one type of transition. That means that each of these is happening on a click. But sometimes you want them to happen automatically, not without waiting for you to click. And so you can do that if you go over here. And here are my animations. So I'm going to select each of those animations. I'm control clicking on each one. Now, up here at the top, it says start. I can start it after previous, which means one's going to appear, then the next one appears, then the next one appears. And so it's going to look like this. Then, after we have our transition coming in, notice each one just appears automatically. I didn't click anything, they just each appeared. I could have them all appear at once. If we go up here to start, with previous means when the one before it starts, this one starts too. So if we preview that, I'm going to get rid of that transition just to save a little bit of time here. But if we now, if we go back here and we preview this slide, notice they just all popped in at once. Okay. So that's something you can do with your transitions. So what you're going to want to do, you can play around. This area up here where it says timing is something that you can play around with because you can have a point appear like we just did. You can have them appear automatically after the previous. You can have them appear on click, which means when you click the keyboard, then the next point appears. When you're giving a live presentation, usually that's what you want to do. You want to point to it, you want it to appear when you're ready for it. But you can play around with those. You can have them take longer time to appear. For example, if I do that, I just made them where it takes 2.75 seconds for each one to appear. That's going to be pretty slow. See how the animation has slowed down a lot. Okay, so you can play with those. You can figure out what you want to do with them. You can change the order. You can also have a motion path. This is something that's kind of cool. Let's say that I have this picture here, and I want it to appear by coming from the top left. Well, what I'm going to do, I have to click here under animation. Here's a motion path and a line. So it shows me a preview, but here's where I can change that. The green tells me where it starts. The red tells me where it ends up. So I just have a line that says it's going to go like that. And so now if I preview this, okay, we have our points. And now that picture slides in there like that. Now, I don't want it to appear immediately, okay? But you can play around with that and see how you want it to do, okay? So that's how you can do a motion path. There are a lot of different motion paths you can have. You can design a custom path for it. Let's say that after it gets down here, I want it to kind of circle around this way. I just kind of draw a path. And so now I'm done. See, that shows me what it's going to look like. So you can have your things fly all over the screen. Okay, so that is how you're going to do motion paths. You can emphasize points. You can exit. You can have points that disappear after you click them. So just play around with the different animation options here. And that's how you'll be doing this assignment.